स्टूडेंट्स, हाउ आर यू ऑल? फाइन, आई होप सो. सो स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज रागनी तिवारी, योर इंग्लिश टीचर, एंड टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट क्लास 12th फ्लेमिंगोज बुक, सेकेंड चैप्टर लॉस्ट स्प्रिंग. सेकेंड चैप्टर लॉस्ट स्प्रिंग, रिटन बाय द ऑथर एनीस जंग. ओके, सो बिफोर नोइंग वट वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी इन दिस स्टोरी, लेट अस नो दिस स्टोरी इन अ ब्रीफ. दैट दिस स्टोरी Lost Spring describes the pitiable condition of poor children who have been forced to miss the joy of childhood due to the socio-economic condition that prevails in this man-made world. These children are denied the opportunity of schooling and forced into labor early in life. Here in this story, Annie's junk. She gives her voice to eliminate child labor by educating the children and to enforce the laws against child labor by the governments strictly. So the call is this, is the end of this story is the child exploitation and the days of the spring that bring joy under their feet. So these are the things which we are going to know in this story. Now I'm going to start the explanation of the story. I hope you all are ready with your pen or pencils to understand the story. So let us start, students. Hear your story. Sometimes I find a rupee in the garbage. It is your tagline of your story. It is a tagline of your story, which is important. Let us know what is the meaning of this line. Sometime I find a rupee in the garbage. Why do you do this? I ask Sahib. As in our previous classes, I have already told you whom I refer here. I refer to the narrator. I refers to the narrator who is narrating the story. The narrator can be your writer too. So I ask Sahib, whom I encounter every morning scrounging for gold in the garbage dumps of my neighborhood. Sahib left his home long ago, set amidst the green fields of Dhaka. His home is not even a distant memory. There were many storms that swept away their fields and homes. His mother tells him that's why they left, looking for the gold in the big city where he now lives. Lots of phrases are here. Let us know. First of all, know what is scrounging. What is scrounging, student? Scrounging means searching something in somewhere. Okay, searching something for gold. Here gold is not actually it refers to something, but it is not actually gold. Okay, we will come to know what is it. So let us explain this paragraph which I read just for you. That in this paragraph, every morning the writer sees a young rag picker boy. What a writer sees? Writer sees, she watches a young rag picker boy, and that boy named Sahib. The rag picker boy who visits the garbage dump near her house, neighborhood, near her house, near the writer's house, and searches for, scrounging for, it has written, searches for or looking for gold in it. Looking for gold in it. See, students, the writer says that he searches for gold. The writer says it ironically, okay? Because although the garbage dump is full of you unless thrown away things, garbage dumps is always full of unless thrown away things, and still he shuffles it so minutely as if he will get something as precious as gold from it. Okay, the rag picker, he was searching in that garbage so minutely, so initially, that he is going to get something as precious as gold. Okay, that's why gold refers here. So the boy's name is Sahib. The boy name is Sahib. His home is in Dhaka. Where was his home? His home was in Dhaka. And was in the middle of lush green fields. They had left it many years ago. Sahib's mother told him that they had left Dhaka many years ago, and he does not remember. Sahib does not remember it anymore. His mother had told him दैट देयर वर मेनी स्टॉर्म्स विच डिस्ट्रॉयड देयर होम्स एंड फील्ड. मेनी स्टॉर्म्स यूज टू केम इन दैट एरिया विच डिस्ट्रॉयड देयर फील्ड्स एंड होम्स. सो हिज मदर यूज टू टेल दीज ऑल थिंग्स टू हिम एंड सो दे लेफ्ट होम एंड शिफ्टेड टू द सिटीज. They left their home and shifted to the cities in search of gold. In search of gold means in search of survivals, in search of things by which they can live their life. The writer again says, looking for gold in the big city. Gold here refers to the something precious which was not available in their hometown. Something which is precious, again the writer emphasizing this line. The writer is emphasizing this line that the gold here refers to the those precious things which was not available in their hometown. The things were like, what are those precious things? For children, the things were like shoes, monies, bags, etc. And for elder ones, for the parents, the things were like the shelter, clothing, all those things, foods, that is means of survivals. So one day the writer questioned Sahib the reason for shuffling through the garbage. One day writer questioned to Sahib that why are you shuffling in this garbage. Okay students, so I have nothing else to do, he mutters here. What is the meaning of mutters, student? Mutter means speak in a low voice. Okay, speak in a low voice. He mutters, looking away, go to school, the narrator says glibly. Glibly here means honestly. The narrator says it very, very honestly that why go to school. Realizing immediately, and as soon as the narrator said that go to school, immediately she realized that how hollow the advice must sound. The how hollow here, meaningless, empty, meaningless. How hollow, how meaningless her advice sounds. Okay, as he said that go to school. So the narrator, when the narrator asked, narrator said, Sahib replies to the writer that he has nothing else to do first of all, other than rag picking. The Sahib replied that he has nothing else to do. I have nothing else to do. I am knowing only rag picking. So the writer suggested that he should go to school. What the writer suggested? That he should go to school. And immediately the writer realized that how meaningless her advice was for that poor boy. He replies that there are no school, okay, in that area. So students, this is it for today. I hope you all have understood this paragraph. Try to listen this video again and again to make it more clear. Till then, take care. Have a nice day.